Welcome to another book review, and it's been a minute. I honestly haven't been reading because I went on kind of a reading book hiatus and basically decided to take a break from reading. So I wasn't reading. I kept traveling, so if you are a part of my channel, you'll notice that I have been still taking my annual trips, but I haven't been reading. The reason for my book hiatus is just, I don't know if others have gone through this, where just the past year, couple months, 6 months, every book that I was getting felt like the same old thing that I read. Even when I tried switching to different genres and such, it's just, or different authors, it just felt like I was reading the same old thing, or it was really cringe writing, it wasn't really good writing, and I would, you know, toss the book aside, try it again after a couple months, toss the book aside, and I was like, I shouldn't have to do that to find a good book. And it wasn't just through Amazon, and it wasn't just through Target or bookstores or even BookTok. I was just getting a lot of duds. A lot of duds where they just weren't keeping my attention. And I dabbled in something else, which I haven't decided if I'm going to review them yet. But yeah, so most recently, I don't even know how it happened. I was at Target and I said, let me just try the book section one last time. And I stumbled across this beauty, Night Shift by Annie Crown. This book, which is obviously what I'm going to be reviewing today, was really, really good. Really, really refreshing. It really reignited my reader's bug, or ignited my fire in regards to reading. So this book is basically, how I interpret it, a comedy, a romantic comedy. It's written basically, ooh, I'm rusty reviewing. I guess you would say third person. Yeah, we're gonna go third person. So like, you're basically the female lead. The book is basically about college nerd bumps into the star basketball player of their university. She works the night shift as a librarian assistant, front desk person, and he's obviously star basketball player. So you're basically following them along their romantic journey, if you will, that basically all began from one night shift where he needed a book and she ended up helping him. What I like about this book, and I'm trying my best not to spoil it because it's really, 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 really well written, is it's romantic and spicy without giving it all to you at once. I don't want to call it a slow burn because it wasn't slow at all. But in regards to the spiciness, I guess you could say it was slow. I can't even say that. Basically, it's not a long book, but it has a great buildup. You really get to be reintroduced with the concept of, it is nerve-wracking when you have a meet cute. It is for anybody, whether it was very relatable. It's relatable to the sense that when you bump into someone and you're flirting, you don't know how the male or the masculine person feels. You don't know how the female or femme person feels. And it's just nerve-wracking, yet it's exciting. Going through the introduction phase of, oh, we're getting to know each other. We go on a couple dates. Are we together? Are we exclusive? Are we not exclusive? Do I have a right to be jealous? Do I have a right not to be jealous? Should I be jealous? It kind of rekindles all those nerves and that people face in regards to dating and entering a relationship, which I feel personally a lot of that's lost nowadays, and it's seen as immature where you're excited when that person texts you. You're excited when that person calls you. You try to make silly chances of encounters just so you could see each other again. There's a lot of things that as I feel like as you get older, you tend to lose sight of. And this book is really like perfect because they are not in high school. They're in college, not just first years in college. They are basically adults, and a lot of people I feel like forget about that. So it was really nice to read about it because it was relatable. When you see a text or you follow that person on social media just to keep up with their day, and because you don't want to text them and seem pushy or clingy or all that stuff. So, and I like it because you see from the feminine female perspective, and you also see it from the male masculine perspective, how it's nerve-wracking on both sides, wondering, oh, does that person like me? And then there's a lot, and then it also breaks down the whole miscommunication where you're thinking, oh, this person's mad at me when they're not really mad at you, or you're trying to place, unrealistic standards on normal people. And how do males and masculine people feel, realizing, oh, this person is a reader and she loves literature and she loves rom-coms and she loves movies. Do I have to sit there and rise to that standard just to get her attention? All of that's discussed in this book in a very beautiful, relatable way. I love how, there is no bad guy or good guy. There is no love triangle. It's just realistically, you're reading about two people falling in love, not rekindling, not, there's no mafia about it. It's just two normal people falling in love, and it was beautifully written. So, it only took me a couple of days because, like I said, once I started reading, I could not put it down. It definitely was the book I needed to re-spark my reading bug. So, again, check it out. It's Night Shift by Annie Crowd. And to the people who stayed and didn't unsubscribe, like some, thank you for waiting and thank you for subscribing. If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, all that jazz. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it.